Hi everyone, my name is Walid and I am a water resources specialist and a GIS specialist. I'm making this video for you from an area called Saraidi in Annaba in the northeastern part of Algeria. It's a very nice undisturbed landscape of this part of the country. I'm making this video to speak about three main points. So the first one is, what does open source mean to me? The second one is, why do I think open source is good for Algeria, and what are my motivations to keep working on it? And the third point is, what am I doing right now to contribute to the open source community? All right, so I started using GIS when I was in when I was doing my bachelor's degree in 2013 in the United States. Back then, I had absolutely no idea what open source was or even what proprietary software was. So I just kept using whatever was given to me back then, which is the obvious choice of S3's ArcGIS. I finished my bachelor's degree in the United States and then I traveled back to Algeria. When I went back, I wanted to start a freelancing business on the side, but I was hit by the surprise that I wasn't able to use the software that was given that I thought was free, because I didn't have to worry about a license when I was at the University of Western Washington University. So I started, I tried to find a solution, and I found that there are cracked versions that you can use. And I kept using that. It's just that the problem was that I wasn't able to continue on or do any freelancing, because what I was doing was illegal and I couldn't prove that I have a license, so I wasn't able to issue any work that was legally recognized. So for those 3 years I was sinning. I kept on sinning with the cracked versions. Until 2016, when I traveled to the Netherlands to UNESCO IHE, and when I started a master's degree in groundwater resources and global change, I met Hans van der Kwast, who is a very famous figure in the QGIS community. And I remember how he was challenging us during the lectures to find things that QGIS is unable to do that ArcGIS is. And I found that at the beginning very arrogant, but of course my challenging side went on to kind of prove him wrong. And I find it very hard to prove. So I started to learn more about the open source concept, and I was immediately hooked and immediately seduced by it, because it appeals to, because as a concept, it gathers the community effort for the greater good of the community. And that just appealed to my socialist and humanitarian side. And since then, I've been promoting open source wherever I go, especially now that I'm in Algeria. So Algeria is undergoing very rough socio-economical challenges that is making it lag in the development of its digital infrastructure. The tendency that exists is to simply import bulk and ready-to-use technological solutions, which might have good short-term impacts, but in the long term, it's not very sustainable. So if not well negotiated to ensure technological transfer and capacity development, that could lead to an inevitable dependency, technological dependency, and to put it softly, the emergence of new digital colonialism. So that's why I think that open source is very good for Algeria and other developing countries, because aside from the financial gains, open source technology offers a room for knowledge sharing and technological transfer that gives the opportunity for these developing countries to simply break from the change of global technological dependency. There are also many opportunities for people in these countries to learn about this technology and actually use it and innovate from it and build upon it using local talent to develop solutions that actually fit and meet the local needs. Now, being convinced of the benefit of open source GIS in Algeria made the choice of what I wanted to do when I come back here to Algeria very, very easy. So since I came back, I started an endeavor with a friend of mine, Mohamed Safar Zitoun, who is a the founder of Geomatic Solutions Company, where we provide services using and relying only on open source GIS solutions. I must admit that we haven't been very successful with providing services, but we've noticed that most of the work that needs to be done to achieve our goal, which is normalizing and democratizing open source GIS in Algeria, was to start simply work on trainings and work on the lowest part of the pyramid, where you just need to introduce the concept kind of eliminate the old habits and prejudice that people have towards open source. And since 2019, we've been making very, very good progress. We are becoming the focal point of open source GIS in Algeria. We have, as an example, we have trained more than 100 participants, academics and also professionals. We have organized and participated in about 10 webinars and conferences. And also, we've been writing blogs just to introduce these concepts and familiarize them in the Algerian community. So I must admit that the road is difficult, but it is very hopeful. The way how I see it is that it is hopeful because I think moving towards open source is the normal or natural way of societies moving towards democratic structures. So I'm very hopeful. Just to finish, as an example of the work that we've done to promote QGIS and open source GIS in Algeria was the last work that we've done with Hans van der Kwast, where we translated his work, his book QGIS for Hydrological Applications. You can find that course available for free on GIS open source open courseware in .org. So GIS open courseware .org. You can also find the videos available on my YouTube channel Moulesig, or MOULESIG, where you can find tutorials and also theoretical videos on GIS concepts. So please follow me on YouTube, follow and take the course, which is given for free. But also, if you are looking for any certified or trainings in Arabic or French, don't hesitate to contact me.